Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us take a moment to acknowledge our sins, so that we may prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, your mighty God and Prince of Peace, Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and the Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, your word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy upon us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Grant that your people, we pray, Almighty God, may ever be watchful for the coming of your only begotten Son, that as the author of our salvation himself has taught us, we may hasten, alert, and with lighted lamps to meet him when he comes, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, your Redeemer, the Holy One of Israel. I, the Lord, your God, teach you what is for your good and lead you on the way you should go. If you were to hearken to my commands, your prosperity would be like a river and your vindication like the waves of the sea. Your descendants would be like the sand, and those born of your stock like its grains. Their name never cut off or blotted out from my presence. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. Those who follow you, Lord, will have the light of life.
Those who follow you, Lord, will have the light of life.
Blessed the man who follows not the counsel of the wicked, nor walks in the way of sinners, nor sits in the company of the insolent, but delights in the law of the Lord and meditates on this law day and night. Those who follow the Lord will have the light of life. He is like a tree planted near running water, that yields its fruit in due season, and whose leaves never fade. Whatever he does, prospers. Those who follow you, Lord, will have the light of life. Not so the wicked, not so. They are like chaff which the wind drives away. For the Lord watches over the way of the just, but the way of the wicked vanishes.
Those who follow the Lord will have the light of life.
Alleluia. Jesus said to the crowds, to what shall I compare this generation? It is like children who sit in the marketplace and call to one another. We played the flute for you, but you did not dance. We sung a drudge, but you did not mourn. For John came neither eating nor drinking, and they said, he is possessed by a demon. The Son of Man came eating and drinking, and they said, look, he is a glutton and a drunkard, a friend of tax collectors and sinners. But wisdom and vindication by her works. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
With one heart, let us offer our prayers to the Lord. For leaders in the church, may they be guided by God's wisdom in all they do, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For local, national, world leaders, may God give them the grace to move away from any hypocrisy and be guided instead by truth, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those traveling the long road of grief, may they know Christ's presence and rest in the confidence that nothing can separate us from the love of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our community of faith, may we be empowered by the Holy Spirit and live a unique call to holiness. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died in the light of faith, may they rest in the presence of God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all the intentions we hold deeply in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Almighty and ever-living God, hear the prayer from which we have presented here before you. May they be answered in due time, according to your will, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine, work of human hands, will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise of the glory of his name, for our good and good of all his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, with our humble prayers and offerings, and since we have no merits to plead our cause, come and pray to our rescue with the protection and the mercy through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, and eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we can watch for the day and inherit the great promise in which we now dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end, we acclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts we pray, by sending down your spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord, Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. the mystery of faith. We proclaim
the Lord and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly, we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Charles, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant our peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of God's peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Amen.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
us pray. Replenished by the food of spiritual nourishment, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that through our partaking in the mystery, you may teach us to judge wisely the things of earth and hold firm to the things of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you.